merges real-time action with strategic command-based combat. For starters, each press of the square button is a swing of Cloud's Buster Sword. Cloud attacks, dodges, and blocks all in real time. His standard attacks do some damage, but they barely scratch the surface of Cloud's true potential. Succeeding on the battlefield requires much more than just hacking and slashing. Cloud needs to be tactical. He needs ATB. Two ATB bars are displayed in the lower right.
Hey, partner, can
you hear me? What's TB? Over time,
but fill much faster as Cloud
Not
lands
you, the other guy.
Standard
yeah.
attacks.
Yeah.
Once an ATB bar is full, you can enter tactical mode, where time slows to a crawl, and you have the
Swardo.
Opportunity to choose actions from the
command. Oh, this is a real time with pause Katase-san, bullshit, dude.
I've had the pleasure of seeing quite a bit of the game, but tactical
you
mode
hate
never
that.
Gets old for me. I could just sit here all day long and watch this beautiful slow motion action.
I recommend play Fallout. This guy doesn't even speak English.
I think the audience would like to see more. Isn't that right, everyone?
Fair enough. Good point.
Yeah.
Well, once in tactical mode, you can choose to perform various abilities, such as Cloud's Braver attack. Using an item in battle will deplete an ATB charge, and if Cloud has the right materia equipped and enough MP, he can use ATB charges to cast spells. Of course, this being a remake, we're sure to see some familiar faces.
Everyone says, you won because of me, you won because of me. It was all a cumulative effort, collaborative. We all helped.
Similar to Cloud, but his abilities are
we all helped each other.
Different. Switching between characters in combat is done with a single button press, which makes rotating through party members a snap. Speaking of other party members, Katase-san, when are we going to see Tifa in action?
This looks pretty fun. It's not like a bunch of angsty teens.
All right.
Finally.
Soon.
Continue to fight even
soon.
I even asked the question if they didn't have it.
It's come out soon.
ATB charges are used.
So you can dumb.
Maybe one day.
By
one day.
Between characters or issuing commands
he's supposed to
say,
right now.
Why don't you tell me when it comes out?
The enemy has a focus gauge that fills up as you do damage. When the gauge is full, the enemy becomes staggered, and you'll deal bonus damage. Tactical mode evokes the command selections from the original Final Fantasy VII and allows players to enjoy battle while taking the time to think strategically. For players who prefer fast-paced action, abilities and spells can be bound to shortcuts for immediate execution. Shortcuts make combat extremely dynamic, but the choice of using them is entirely up to you. Right, Katase-san?
That's right. The game has been made so that you can choose how to play. I hope players get excited about this.
Well, that's a brief introduction to combat in Final Fantasy VII Remake, and we look forward to showing you a whole lot more in the coming months. For now, let's see how Cloud and Barret do against a more formidable foe.
Spoilers.
Showing Tifa because they changed her to be black and have like a shaved head half haircut.
It's on you.
Well, it's a remake. They can't do that. They didn't do that back then.
They can do whatever they want.
No, this is pretty dope. Game looks.
That'd be cool if they did do it because then people wouldn't be able to say anything about it. Like, what?
Oh. This game looks okay. What do you think about this game, Alphonse?
Looks cool.
See the difference in everyone's presentation? People were resident sleeping, the other ones. This one's... Oh. Pog champ all day.
Damn time!
Would you play Final Fantasy VII Alphalock? All right. You're banned.
Oh, sorry, I was muted. Have I played Final Fantasy VII? No.
Me neither. But I've seen the cutscenes.
Yes,
have you
for
seen
like
the cutscenes?
An hour.
Have you seen the cutscenes?
No. I played for like an hour.
You didn't even watch the cutscenes? Even I watched the cutscenes. Some of them. Basically all of them. Basically.
I can't play games anymore. Or ever.
Alright. Ever is a long time. This two-player? It can't be. There's no way. This is a switching characters. It's like Monster Hunter, but better. Way better. Why does it look... I think there's something wrong with my computer. It looks all pixely and shit. Is that me? Is that just me? Alright, Blue. Thank you so much for helping us. That was my first victory, man. Good luck with your Overseer grind. Blue's like a professional YouTuber who has to get the max level to find out all the content. To talk about it.
We did some kind of move.
I wonder if Fatal Existence is going to be in this game. AKA Sephiroth. The carry? Are you kidding me? Oh shit.
Please welcome Tetsuya Nomura, director, Final Fantasy VII Remake.
They're teasing the Sephiroth.
Thank you for joining us, Nomura-san. It is an absolute honor to have you here. Katase-san, how do you feel working with Nomura-san once again on Final Fantasy VII Remake?
はい、彼からですね、原作の FF7 以降、まあ、何作も、ね、一緒にね、その後も仕事はしてるんですけども、
Is the audio weird for
you? ディレクション
とキャラクターデザインそして、ね、
ストーリーとね、がっつり組むのはまた久しぶりなのでね、22年前、
He was always an asshole, but now he's a blind asshole.
でも取り組んでる姿を見てね、私も正直ね、喜んでます。
Since the original Final Fantasy VII,
I've quoting
worked
a
with him on many titles, but it has been a while since we've actually had him work
that
so heavily on a project like this.
Reminds me of the guy from
like
Billy
this,
Madison.
From the direction to character design to the story, and I'm really happy to see
Not
him working
way.
On this title with the same passion that he had 22 years ago.
He can still get it up.
Hi. 結構長い間お待たせしましたが、ずっと応援してくださっている 皆様、
wow, really?
本当にありがとうございました。
oh,
そしてですね、
yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
皆さんあの今日初めて、
yeah.
プレイ画面を
yep. Yep.
結構長めに見たと思いますが、おそらく想像してたものとは少し違ったんじゃないかなと、思っております。
Okay, that's interesting.
So first and foremost, I wanted already. To extend our gratitude to those who have been waiting so patiently and have been supporting us for such a long time until now. And also, we've taken a look at gameplay right now, and we've barely showed you a good bit.
でですね、まあ、そういうわけなので、皆さん、
He wanted his mama. He was like,
ma. 見たいじゃないかなと思います。
With that tattoo, that tattoo. on the left. Oh shit, you guys are gonna see it. Pretend you do. Pretend you see it.
And I was wondering, do you guys want to actually play the game?
ということでですね、明日から開催されます E3 のですね、
スクエアニ
ックスブースの方で、
Released right now.
セブンリメイク、プレイアブル出展していますので、ぜひ機会のある方は、触れてみてください。
So we actually have playable demo kiosks available at the Square Enix E3 booth. So I hope you have the opportunity to try it out.
It's just Final Fantasy 15 with it's the same engine.
それではですね、最後に、皆さんにご覧いただきたいものがありますので、
My illusion's broken. Like, I know they're just recycling the engine for every game.
コンサートの方でショート版のトレーラーを公開しましたけども、
Until they get all the money out of it.
ロング版をご用意してますので、ぜひご覧ください。
So finally, there is something that we wanted to show you. Yesterday, we showed you a short version of a trailer at the Final Fantasy VII concert. Today, we have a longer version.
80-hour concert.
All right, please take a look.
Are you kidding me, Rusty? Are you kidding me? And Geo. I've seen the cutscenes for this game, guys. I get it. Basically. Pizza.
These sewer rats appear to call themselves Avalanche, sir.
Damn.
For saving my life. You think he's a keeper?
Oh my god.
I actually like the characters in this one.
Y'all gotta look at the bigger picture here. Nothing worth fighting for was ever won without sacrifice.
Help me!
Thank God they showed her, because
that Veronica Vaughn
is what it.
I know we have to think big if we're going to make a difference, but not like this. I just
was a psych out.
I feel trapped.
Mm-hmm.
Bunch of
this game looks. I'm buying this game. I'm buying this.
Get going.
Okay. Are you buying this up?
I might. I've always wanted to play one of these, but
you play the mobile one.
I do. I like the mobile game, and I like I've never played an RPG with like the action combat, yeah. So it looks interesting.
If anyone's worth it, this one probably is.
I also heard that was it 15 or something?
Cloud. Oh, dang.
Run away. You have to leave. You have to live.
You bastard!
What? Where's the subtitles?
Hold on to that hatred.
I said fly, you fools.
Fly, you fools. Amazing. Wait. Okay.
What is it? 3-3?
Isn't there another game coming out 3-3? Oh, damn. The deluxe edition. That was hot.
Now, that's the entire game. It's not like the...
People are standing.
All you get is the motorcycle figurine thing for $1,000.
In GameStop, I saw like a bunch of toys for sale. It's expensive shit. Then, like, the next time I go there, they change the entire showcase. Well, I guess the Final Fantasy's over now. It's the trash games.
Oh, cool. What is this?
Life is Strange. Hey.
Oh, I hate Life. That's my most hated game of all time.
Oh, I understand.
I know what happened. I don't like Gossip Girl. I don't like the CW Network. And I don't like Life is Strange games.
It shows our Tumblr. It shows. Ready when you are, Master. So excited. Where's my reaction?
Oh my god.
Show me.
Oh my gosh, guys.
What if they showed me? I'd probably look the same. Boy, it was trash game. You'll be fine, Daniel. As long as we're
together. I want to see what his power can do. Come on, Daniel. You got this. It's just so freaking cheesy.
Spoilers. You know? Oh shit, Gold Glove. There's spoilers, man. I guess they really want
he
people
floats.
To
play. Oh my god.
I miss Dad. I'm so sorry, Daniel.
Oh, wait, I think that...
I'm really glad I got to meet you.
It's the same for me.
Bro hug. What a nice dude, man.
Oh my god.
It's the puppy!
The puppy!
We got a puppy!
I hate people.
I want to see a game that advertises that it has 1 out of 10 scores.
That's so sad.
Stop, Daniel. I said stop.
This is a spoiler. I wanted to play this eventually.
No, never play it, MP. Never.
I played the first episode.
Remember that?
Were you there for that? You were there.
I probably left.
Russ, he said, stop being a negative.
Why? Why can't I be negative? Why is everybody got to be positive all the time?
You're like George Costanza. Why you got to be negative? Why you got to be positive all the time? Who said you got to be negative?
Who's got to be positive? Can I be negative?
You can be negative. It's fine.
If we had no dang right, I could be negative. Would consume
us all. What the hell is this game?
I come from an entire family of negative people. It's a rich negative genealogy.
I guess the game, Dragon Quest 30.
Final Fantasy Crystal Chronicles Remastered Edition. This winter, embark on a new journey.
Enough with the Final Fantasy.
This winter, we remade another game. I'd like to try Final Fantasy 12.
Square Enix is like RPG Andy.
This world is full of mysteries.
Has Rusty played Final Fantasy 12? I doubt it. Damn millennial.
Whoa. This game looks cool.
Nope.
Let's end this, shall we?
My brand, I'll strike you down.
I'm ready for you.
This is our chance.
I'm
Octopath Traveler. It's a Octopath Traveler.
Yeah, I'm really hyped for that Final Fantasy VII.
Can't wait till 3/3/2020.
See, Elfwalk, listen to me right now. It's that time's gonna pass like that. Tomorrow, you'll see, we're gonna play it and I'm gonna be like, Elfwalk, remember that day I told you the time's gonna pass to 3/3? This is the time.
I'd be like, no, I don't remember. It was so long ago.
You're gonna say that. It's gonna be funny. Because you're gonna remember it, actually.
I hope not.
And we're both gonna say, wow, that's funny, because like we remembered exactly what we said.
Yeah.
It was actually a meme. You think it ends there? No. Then we're gonna say that, wow, remember I kept going even though it was already over? We'd said everything that needed to be
right.
said?
And then I'll be like, yeah, I'll pretend I don't, even though I clipped the entire thing and saved it and set a reminder on my phone to remind us.
That's kind of weird. That'd be weird if you couldn't join because you were banned by then.
It's bigger, it's better, it's the one, the only, the builder's builder of a game.
See, they started with the pearls.
Oh,
what? What is this? Do you know what this is?
Yeah, Dragon Quest Builders 1 was the best.
Really?
The building, cooking, and creation of all things, and
with art by Dragon Ball Z guy.
All hope seems to be lost until you.
Oh shit! This looks actually good.
Manages to escape the clutches of
from the Dragon Ball Z guy. Washed up on the deserted shores. It looks like Trigun. Spiky hair. I would color that the lighter blonde, lighter.
It is up to you to doff your mallet and club, unravel the riddles of this land, and defeat the hateful children of Harkon.
That story's kind of shitty, but okay.
Travel the diverse islands and discover your true potential.
This looks like Maple Story plus there is a land of adventure. That other game, but it's way better.
Minecraft.
This actually looks way better though.
New crafting skills on each island. With more to do.
I heard the first one's real good. Like no joke.
It's like the same graphics.
Yeah.
Everything in Dragon Quest Builders.
Was this only for Switch?
Much bigger. Build huge structures in a larger world with more
at least on PS4
options than ever before, and with a little help from the eager islanders. The world is humongous, and you'll need your wits about you to get around. Run
islanders are
fields and explore ruins,
eager.
Treacherous mines and spectacular castles. Dive into
my time at Portaria as well, but like way better. Actually a triple A budget
to catch the sunset and glide home to rest up for your next day of adventure.
But why though?
But beware, monsters roam this land and will need to be dispatched with cunning composure.
Oh shit, it's not like real time strategy, it's real time.
An aggressive amnesiac with a fondness for
what's up, Yoruba?
Use powerful attacks on the battlefield to take down.
We're just saying what games
beasts.
It looks like. Looks like this.
Work together with your villagers to.
This is a long trailer. This is too long, guys.
That's what they all say.
Be sure to customize the way you build your fields to support the kind of crops you're growing. Harvest anything from the humble cabbage and wheat to tantalizingly tasty tomatoes.
That might be too much stuff to do.
Big projects require big
dude, turtle shell outfit.
Wait, is
you and three friends
is online?
Team up online to build anything you can imagine.
Ooh.
Let your creativity run wild.
No way, dude. Is it on PC?
Probably not.
The only limit is your imagination. So
hackers
call your
on PC.
And build your fate together.
Third person Minecraft.
The road you build is paved with peril, young builder. Only you
this
can
is
defeat
like,
the children of Hargon.
It's like Fortnite, save the world.
What's that farm? That farming one that's like Maple Story that's newer that people play.
I don't know.
talking about?
July 12th.
Well, what am I talking about, Elmo?
PS4 only. PS4.
You're in the town and...
Only on PS4. Who the hell's gonna play that now?
You.
No, no, no. DLC? I could buy this game. Should I buy this game, you think? What's that girl's name who's playing this off walk?
I don't remember.
Let's do this. I believe in you. I believe in the Luminary.
Oh, Dollface.
Dollface. Dollface. Dollface or Dollface? Dollface. Interesting.
Dollface. She was playing it.
I think. Oh, she's probably still playing it. That shit's long.
Might be playing it right now.
Next is of an exclusive Age Definitive Edition S Billion. Well, I guess I'll wait for that one instead. That's the guy who looks like Trunks.
What's this? Something new.
I have to pee, but I don't want to leave. Well, this looks interesting. There's so many games.
These are already out? I've never heard of any of those.
Same.
That one looks good.
Boundless. Remember Boundless Elfwalk? Oh, man.
I think I left on those ones.
Did I post a video on that? That shit was pretty good.
I like the anime one.
There's some good ones.
Hello, everyone. This is Carolina.
Alberto and Carlos Mastretta.
So diverse.
A car racing game?
We're a family of motorsport fans from Mexico, and we're the founders of Original Fire Games.
Something wrong with their, like, connection.
We have seen a fascinating evolution in racing.
The whole time.
Nowadays, you can drive. She's a robot, I think. It's a deep fake, and it's glitching out.
However, we believe it's time to try something different. We want to do this by reviving a style that pioneered racing games decades ago.
Our game?
Oh, what the fuck?
Which brings together a whole range of
that was cool, cartoony.
Of motorsport.
We are the it's a Micro Machines ripoff.
And show a sneak preview of our game, which Square Enix Collective will publish in 2020.
Join us for the ride, and see you again soon.
But you don't like yourself, but you want the real stuff.
I mean,
oh, it's like slot cars.
Yeah, it looks cool too, I guess.
They're trying to bring it back, Elfwalk. They're trying to bring it back to how it was. It was a good idea. I mean,
it's like RC Pro-Am or something.
Steam. Oh, German sold that? Is streaming? Oh.
Battalion 1944 recaptures the core of classic competitive first-person shooters. You'll need to quickly coordinate strategies with your team on the fly. Whilst keeping
is this
your
a mobile game?
No, it can't be.
Why does it look like this?
There are multiple game modes for you and team to dive into. Test your skills in domination, capture the flag, or team deathmatch.
No, that's
perfect
mobile.
Your tactics
that's
in the highly competitive
game.
Wartide game mode. Face It's competitive toolset is fully integrated into the game, bringing world-renowned competitive matchmaking.
They got people hyped with that Final Fantasy.
Rankings and leaderboards.
Yeah, why didn't they close with Final Fantasy?
I better end with something weird. They're probably gonna show like Kingdom Hearts DLC. And unlock visual customization rewards.
Each season will bring challenges for you to complete and medals to unlock, whilst tracking your in-game accomplishments and providing you with an easy way to compare them against your friends via in-game leaderboards. Halt the Axis offensive in their tracks with the Rapid Fire PPSH, or take fire with pixel precision with the Mosin Nagant, and a whole host of new weapons just as deadly as their owners.
I need a request to get a free key for this game.
With a range of environments to test your skills in, and a variety of weapons at your disposal.
On your phone?
Play as a team, and compete to be top of the leaderboards.
What the hell was that? I just see the anime ass. What does that mean? Wait, that's been on for like 44 years or something. Alright, well, show us the good stuff already, bitch. Hold on. What else could they show? That's all they got off. That's all they have. There's nothing else that they can show us that can blow our mind. There's nothing. There's nothing else.
They have their own cloud streaming service where you could play all the games on your phone.
When I'm on the on Spotify. Nice. That's pretty cool. Okay, for that, I mean, spoilers. You gotta love this game, Outpuck, right? You like this game, right? What the hell is this? Arena mode, maybe. Cheese mode. Bro, moment. Commands. What is going on? I don't know what's going on here. I don't know.
Now, how did that happen?
It doesn't make any difference. Besides, the balls were inert.
Who are you, though? Who are you, simulator? Remind.
The Let Me Tell You About It edition.
New Kingdom Hearts, I guess. A new edition? Or is it a new game?
Please welcome.
Nobody knows.
Yoshida. Producer and director, Final Fantasy XIV Online.
He's a big deal guy, director of the whole game. I like the music. It's like some.
Comes the like, cool. She's got her notebook.
He has diamond teeth. What the fuck? That's where all the DLC money's going to. That's where all the microtransaction money's going to. His diamond teeth.
すいません、短い時間ですが、僕からはいよいよこの7月2日発売となるファイナルファンタジー14拡張パッケージ第3弾漆黒のヴィランズの紹介をさせていただきます。
I have no idea what he's saying.
So we'd like to take a little bit of your time to show off Shadowbringers Final Fantasy 14's third expansion pack, which is releasing on July the 2nd.
Oh my god. I can't wait.
発売されてから6年が経ちました。なんと世界で累計
I tried to play it, but like so much bullshit happened. I couldn't. I had the launcher open, but there was an update. I was like, fuck this.
There's always an update. I hate that. And I had
to register my email. Bullshit.
It's been 6 years since the release of A Realm Reborn in 2013. And over the years, we have surpassed 16 million total registered users. Plus, we have reached the highest number of active subscribers in history, in its history, before the launch of Shadowbringers. This is all thanks to our players, our Warriors of Light.
このシャドーブリンガーズではですね、拡張パッケージにとどまらない新作 RPG 一本分のボリュームと、そしてゲーム体験をお届けしたいと思います。
We view Shadowbringers as more than a simple expansion pack, but as a new game filled with volume and gameplay experiences that are comparable to a brand new standalone RPG title.
また新ジョブであるガンブレイカー、それから踊り子、新種族のロスガルとビエラなど、
nice shirt he has there. Nice shirt. 多数の新規の要素が用意されています。
And there's so many new elements in the game for those who have yet to play Final Fantasy XIV, including two new jobs, the Gunbreaker and the Dancer, as well as two new playable races, the Frothgar and the Viera.
New racists?
ぜひ Final Fantasy シリーズの最新作として Final Fantasy VII リメイクの発売2020年3月3日までの間、漆黒のヴィランズをお楽しみください。
He said something about the Final Fantasy VII remake.
Shadowbringers, that's the latest installment in the Final Fantasy franchise for our fans to enjoy. At least until 2020 March 3rd,
seven.
When Final Fantasy VII remake comes out.
それでは、いよいよ7月2日、ローンチとなりますが、この場で世界初公開となる、その漆黒のヴィランズのローンチトレーラーをご覧いただこうと思います。
We are pleased to bring a world premiere of the launch trailer for Shadowbringers releasing on July the 2nd.
Please take a look!
Oh my god! Dude, look, Alphox, are you excited?
Yes.
And when, pray tell, did we last have a dark night?
Very excited.
Over 100 bleeding years ago, that's
I'm buying this. I can't wait. When's it come out? July 2nd?
2020.
I already requested that entire month off work.
I requested the whole 2 years off work for all these games coming out.
What Orange saw was the future.
Ah, it's a Warrior of Light.
Shadowbringers. This time, they're bringing the shadows. This game seems cool, but I don't know.
That's how the Sin Eaters came to be. They were once
it can't be.
Creatures. It's venom. But white.
The eternal light of these creatures has confounded us for nigh on 100 years. For each we have put down, another has risen up in its place. Born of the self-same ether relinquished by its predecessor.
Ether.
In the ether. To consume by primordial acts, the land must cleanse once again before the Warriors of Light can diminish the shadows.
Oh, damn. There's some bestiality going on there.
Sin Eaters are part of Yulmor society, but they must be fed with ether. Living ether.
You guys got more chins than a Chinese phone book.
That's not good.
This world's beyond saving. Like those who try to save it. This world has had its fill of heroes.
This world has had its fill of fills. Is that Loki? On the Loki? Dude, the music's so good. Where can I get an app store where I can listen to this while I'm on the go?
available now on iTunes, Spotify, and Apple Music, and Amazon Music, Pandora.
The time has come for Pandora Enix Music. I wonder who's gonna win. Are the bad guys gonna win? I mean, oh,
they might.
Eat the shatter, the tyranny.
Not the tyranny of the light.
People are sick of this shit. Look, sleepers. Become what you must.
And then they'll show like Cloud at the end, and everyone will lose their shit.
Become the warrior of darkness. Groovy. Shadowbringers. 40.
Through prayer and sacrifice, the will of the star was made manifest.
I'm sorry, I can only assume I misheard, but it sounded an awful lot like you were implying both Zodiac and Hydaelyn are not gods.
But they are gods after a fashion, yes. The eldest and most powerful of primals.
There's higher level gods? Bioshock.
Marvel vs. Capcom.
I already like the music in this.
Destiny 2. Mortal Kombat. Cheese. Cheese was.
Dying Mirror's Light Edge Zombie Edition.
Cheetos. It is. You called it. You got it. Nice song, isn't it? Oh, we. That sucks. You're watching it live with me? Oh. Mirror's Edge Dying Light. Basically the same thing. Who's that guy? The HD. That doesn't look that good. Don't close up.
This is going to be something big. This is the...
This is it. The Spyro the Dragon.
Last one? Or is this the second to last one?
This is it, man. Dragon Warrior 80. What the hell is this shit? Dude, this looks like Chrono Trigger. What the fuck? It's like the same thing. What the fuck, dude? What the hell is this? I thought they were gonna show like HD, what it looks like back then, and the HD version. It's just, this is what it looks like.
I mean, it's one that never came and never had an English translation before. Oh, yeah.
Whoa. Sega. Oh, here's the HD. What the hell, he's a giant.
Like, this is the type of game that I would never be able to play. Like, if you gave me that game and was like, I'll give you $1,000 if you beat this game, I wouldn't be able to beat it. I'd be like, yeah, fuck it.
What about $1,000,000?
For $1,000,000, I probably could do it.
That's right.
It's like there's two more picture frames.
The empty void.
Final Fantasy Brave Exvius. Enjoyed by fans the world over, has surpassed 39 million downloads.
This isn't the one that I played.
Now, Square Enix proudly presents the international reveal of a new title born from the FFBE universe. War of the Visions.
Is it Mega Man Legends?
Final Fantasy Brave Exvius.
Dude, if Mega Man Legends gets announced tomorrow,
and War of the Visions,
dude, I'm gonna lose my
W-O-T-V
shit.
WOTV FFBE.
Dude, if Mega Man Legends comes out tomorrow, dude, I'm gonna fucking lose it.
This is the story of Ardora, a continent of Lapis. A tiny spark here ignites the flames that would embroil the entire continent.
It ignites the flames of the broiled embers of the broiled.
A conflict later spoken of as the War of the Visions.
This is so absurdly cheesy that I kind of like.
Ruled by
the penis fanboy.
Possesses the power of visions.
The power of visions. Princes. And the monarch of flame and fire.
The white
everything's
male.
On fire and
the
bulls.
Western kingdom,
the bull horns. The horny people.
And it's brave.
There's
and
the white males. White people. Okay, where's all the.
Explosion.
The snake of the demon. The Thanos. The Thanos.
The barbarian tribes into
the barbarians.
Mightiest
boobs.
I would join this team. Oh man. Let me tell you about him.
Was it?
House Stark.
Arctisite would choose this one. Milady.
Hitler.
Sanctum, Hitler land.
A religious city-state with believers throughout Ardor, founded by one who claims to be.
It's only one guy.
Each burden with its own dignity. Thus is the curtain drawn.
That's me. That's who I'd be. The guy by himself.
Rests.
Everybody just abandoned.
Abandoned? Do you mean you left him?
One's homeland.
Let's be honest.
Same difference.
War of the Visions.
Maybe so.
Final Fantasy Brave Exvius.
Dude, I'm buying that. I'm buying that one. I'm buying that one. I'm buying that one. I'm buying
What's
that
it called?
One. I'm buying. I don't know.
It's War of the Visions Exodus Final Fantasy Requiem.
Gears of War. Oh, Judgment.
Are they talking about, like, Cliff Bleszinski?
Me? No. This is Brand X. Not actual game. Another shaved female. Killing man. I like her though. I like her smoky eye. It's the dangling man. That's the thing from the thing. Fall 76, the cave.
War of the Worlds.
This looks like that looks cool. They show gameplay
that's
though.
That's like one that'll never come out.
Are you kidding me?
Summer. I doubt it. I doubt we'll ever see that game ever again.
Please welcome Sebastian Wojciechowski, studio head, People Can Fly.
All right. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Sebastian Wojciechowski, studio head of People Can Fly, the studio behind Bulletstorm and Gears of War Judgment. Yeah, any Bulletstorm fans in the house?
Right. Judgment was like infamously shit on for being trash.
To be able to finally
you know that Outlook?
Outriders.
Huh?
Gears of War Judgment was like known for being shittiest, the shittiest Gears of War.
I'd like to thank the team.
Just like, I don't know.
You guys are
I don't know why he's mentioning that. Like it's a big thing.
It's 4 a.m. in the morning.
From the director of Critters 2. And
for that, please.
It's 4 a.m. at night.
How to Survive Edge Weapons.
Thank you. Thank
new
you.
Movie coming.
And of course, Square Enix for the help and support as we work together on this exciting new IP. You know, over the past few years, people
new IP men.
Has grown to over 200 developers and 4 studios across Poland,
it is nice to see
UK,
something new.
And most recently, the U.S.
That's
to bring
true.
You what is our most ambitious shooter to date.
I want to hit their mics. I want
to
use that mic.
To present more of our vision, I would like to take this moment to introduce a short video from our game director, Bartek Mita. So thanks a lot.
Everyone's name is like hard to say in
this winter. Thank you.
Is it Bartek Mita? Her face. Look at her face up.
Are they going to show gameplay?
Shooters are in our DNA. It's our passion. And it's what we do.
It's what we do.
Outriders.
Oh, that was the gameplay.
Draws on all our experience from all our previous titles. It's a game.
He's like, what am I doing?
We wanted to make for a very long time. We describe Outriders as a dark, modern shooter built with traditional values. By that, I mean we are creating an experience with a strong story that you can enjoy with your friends or on your own. We want to tell a complete story.
This looks like a cool game, though. Even without looking at
a shooter with a powerful gunplay,
oh,
incredible weaponry.
Oh. The universe, think about it.
And a hostile
this
new world.
Weapon models are kind of
we want to spend many hours.
What is that? I think they're cool. It's like Doom
it's
third person.
It's in our heads ever since People Can Fly left Epic Games. Outriders is a 1-2 or 3 player drop in, drop
three
out,
player.
Drop shooter.
You gotta get
in
this one
game,
out.
You create your own Outrider. And journey across the hostile planet of Enoch.
Create your own.
Of the source of a mysterious signal.
Create your own Outrider.
It's a pretty dark and unforgiving world. And yes, there is a lot more depth to the game, but I can't say too much more right now.
I think it's a fake game that will never come out. I just got a feeling about it.
I think it's gonna be the best. That was the picture frame, the last one. The last one. There's two more? Two more picture frames. Three more. 80 more picture frames. I like the Outsiders. That looks good, dude.
Reincarnation is the foundation of our way of
that
life.
That looks fun, man. I'll tell you about it.
We celebrate the lives we've been given and offer up prayers for the next.
This is
it is grief of death which shackles the living and causes the dead to stray.
Diablo 3 clone?
Indeed, there is no greater affront to reincarnation. So we turn our grief to joy as we send off the dead. But the souls of those who held back their
dreams
still need salvation in death.
His name is Kushi.
A duty that falls to the Watchers. The Watchers sever the bonds that tie the lost to this world and send them off.
What do you think about this one, Alphonse? You have to get this one. This looks like Soul Worker, dude. Yo, wait, now, no, wait a minute. I like this a lot. I like this game a lot. I'm buying this. Bye. Are you buying it, Elf Rock?
Looks pretty cool.
It does. That's what I'm saying.
It's probably like a Switch exclusive or something.
No, I bet you $1 billion. But... Oh, who's that guy? Dark purple. That's a good guy. Onikani.
August 22nd, PS4 and Steam. Oh.
Oh.
Yeah, I'll get that one if it's got multiplayer. It looks good.
I would.
Okinuki.
Okinuki.
Oh shit.
I bet I had to pee. Bye bye. A remastered?
I played this one actually. I played
my sister played this one.
Until the third disc.
Oh, my sister only played it for like an hour.
Sethir and the sorcerer chick and Squall and their stupid sword.
I'll probably play this as well. Yep. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I'm gonna play this. I have a history with this one. I have a stake in this one. Pretty cool. That's pretty hype. 2019. Hey, that's this year.
On Steam.
Why do we like Steam so much? Why? Do we give Steam too much credit? It's the fucking achievements. Like, there's no point in the achievements, but it's just there. Okay.
What? Avengers. It's Endgame.
I'm watching. Oh, this is Ultimate Alliance 3. I thought that was a real person.
Hello,
San Francisco! Thor, Tony, check it out. Check it out, Tony. At once. Why do you say at once? What a nerd. Check it out at once.
It's so weird when they're not...
Those people.
Yeah.
Yeah, fuck the transformation, just do it.
Yeah, they didn't even show him transforming. They just did a
hard
cut.
This looks
cut.
Pretty good, though. I actually wouldn't mind playing any of these characters. They're all cool. Except Black Widow, she sucks.
Was that a joke? Did Thor make a joke? Cat, they got pulsar tanks.
Black Widow might be actually cool in this. The only person with guns.
Oh no. Captain America. Some say they were set up. Was he on that thing when it blew?
Nah.
Others call them murderers.
Do the Avengers pose a danger to society? That was the question, Bruce.
The hell?
That was the question.
Well, we all lost something that day.
Drones. It's like Superman.
But that's not how this story ends.
They're fighting the drones.
Did you see Endgame, MT?
Basically.
There was something that happened in that movie. I don't want to spoil it.
The Captain America?
Yeah, but Captain America and Thor.
Oh, the hammer?
Yeah, how... Well, what was
welcome.
With that?
Because he's Sean noble Sky, enough.
Creative director, what Crystal Dynamics,
how,
and Bill Roseman.
He has the right
he
soul.
He tried in the past and it didn't work.
He was Marvel pretending Games. He couldn't lift it so Thor wouldn't be offended.
Oh, okay.
Maybe. Maybe he almost did, but thank didn't you. Do it. Because it wasn't Civil War yet. Once he got that dark side
you,
out of
thank
him.
You everyone. We
that's
are
another theory.
Incredibly excited to reveal Marvel's Avengers to the world.
What? It's not Ultimate Alliance 3. It's just another game.
A few years ago, Crystal Dynamics and Marvel began collaborating on an original Avengers game. One that combined epic action adventure
Crystal Dynamics
with cinematic
does the Tomb Raider games. I actually like
a game
those games.
Where we
the one that Boss Hoss plays
can experience in both single player
probably.
And co-op what it's
the
like
three
to
newest
be
ones.
Earth's mightiest heroes.
Do I have any true believers in the house?
Yeah. Woo!
Awesome.
I believe
because
believe
you
what?
Will instantly recognize your favorite superheroes and villains. But
I'm a did he say believe? I thought he said believe.
Game,
I'm a believer.
As Crystal's interpretation of these iconic characters.
Our story begins at A-Day, as San Francisco celebrates the opening of the Avengers West Coast headquarters. And the team's custom helicarrier, outfitted with a strange experimental energy source. However, the day turns deadly when an attempt to steal this new technology results in massive destruction. Blamed for the tragedy, the Avengers are outlawed and our heroes disband.
5 years later, a horrific evil threatens the world. And our only hope is to reassemble Earth's mightiest heroes.
We get it.
You'll
the are the Avengers, yes.
Avengers in an all new,
an all new. We're very excited to show you a first look.
It's not that deep. I mean, we get it. It's the Avengers. Most
and the demo is available on the show floor. Yeah.
They have superpowers, okay, guys? Capes, suits.
Like, oh shit, now we gotta add Hawkeye and
most
redesign
this
Sonic.
This is a story about self-acceptance in the face of adversity. About embracing our individual powers and learning that together we are mighty.
Mighty.
You'll lead the team as the legendary super soldier, Captain America. You'll call down
I think if you like Captain America, you're racist. You're racist. Okay.
You'll channel the
where's Kratos?
Anger of scientist Bruce Banner by unleashing the Hulk.
Yeah.
You'll gather intel and strike swiftly as the ultimate tactical spy, Black Widow. And finally, you'll blast through the sky as the charismatic Tony Stark. Known to the wider world as the Armored Iron Man.
The Armored Iron Man, that's what I would have said.
Armored Armored Man.
To bring
man.
This incredible story to life, we've assembled an all-star
he
cast.
Ironed his clothing as well.
I'll let them introduce themselves.
Oh, the entire cast is here.
That TV is really going up slowly.
Oh, they're not here, they're just, they made a video.
Hey, it's not me.
So, here we are. Avengers Assemble. Who are you people again?
Hi, I'm Troy Baker, and I play Bruce Banner.
Troy
Hi,
Baker.
I'm Jeff Shine, and I play Captain America.
Wait, who's Troy
I'm
Baker?
Travis Willingham,
doesn't
and
he
I
do
play
like
Thor.
A, something
Hi,
else
playing
else?
Are we supposed to know all these people?
Troy Baker Hi, does the voice North, for Snake, right? Star. Or
something. Nolan North
have to
is
be, talked into.
Batman, right?
You know, Troy so Baker. Like Troy Baker. Something with it. I know
yeah,
this
yes.
guy's name. unless he's a porn
you know,
star, I don't know.
Portrays him as
but
this super
the name is very familiar.
Character.
I think it's a mask.
Troy Baker. For him. I think Troy he's like one of the most Baker. Vulnerable
guys. I think Bruce is just such
so
a.
So basically,
cool
these are superheroes. They have powers, really okay?
Like we, bring out the big green.
What are they going to tell us that's that, surprising? I don't
that
know.
Bruce is a super complex character.
We know who they are.
Played him before.
What is very relatable about Natasha is she's.
She's a woman.
Capable, but she's at the
she has
core.
An ass.
She's human. She's what? Surrounded by
Troy Baker,
all of this larger than life.
You're thinking
stuff,
Jim Baker.
Step up to it.
I feel like Thor got really interesting in the last like 10 or 15 years. For me, I like where he's kind of landed in the public eye. You know,
one of the things I think is cool about Cap is I never feel like he necessarily.
Cap.
Wants to be a leader.
He thinks he's cool enough to say Cap. Are you kidding me?
But Captain right America is does seem as well. Pretty antiquated.
He was in Lupin the Third.
Great, so I think everybody's going
invisible.
To
be blind. Dude,
Troy Baker. Troy Baker was in Lupin the Third. Dude.
Do not
oh,
shake.
Troy Baker. he does Dragon Ball
for
stuff.
Us. Can't wait for you to be able to play the
yeah,
game.
Everybody
right
does.
Now, you don't have to wait.
My cousin does Dragon
Troy
Ball
Baker
stuff.
Is Batman versus. He was in Batman.
What about Nolan North? Who's
Troy
that?
Baker
is
the
Batman
voice for Lego Batman. He's the Lego Batman
that was,
voice.
That was the question.
Did you even is Nolan North sense? Batman?
It was a wait, this is a movie, Batman and Ninja Turtles? I didn't watch that shit.
The Terrigen reactor was unstable, and you
is that already
knew
out?
That. You knew that, and you still paraded it before the entire world. So what? We just give up. We didn't give up, Tony. We failed.
Dude, why is Bruce Banner such a bitch all the time?
No, we failed him.
And Tony Stark, every time he falls, he grows him. His hair out. He does weed. Like, relax, Tony. God damn.
Please welcome Scott Amos, head of studio.
Scott,
wait, what?
Marie, senior community and
Scott
social
towels.
Media manager, Crystal Dynamics.
Scott Amos. Oh.
Amos.
Oh.
Hello, E3.
No, no.
With one dude, T. Scott with one T.
There's a baseball. There's a baseball player called Woody Gold. Johnson.
Seen a high level view. Of the cinematic and
character. How are you just gonna have that name
of Marvel's Avengers?
Woody Johnson.
But are they still talking about
only
this?
The beginning of this adventure.
Marvel must have said, okay,
Marvel's
if we make
Avengers
this game, you have to say it, to mention it a lot.
Multiple years with exciting new content released.
Dude, slight
on a
cleavage.
Basis.
Slight cleavage there.
Like the Avengers.
What is
you
this?
And your
is that a jacket or
together.
A cape?
You'll assemble into teams of up to four players.
I think it's an orange.
What is that?
Look at his ass. Look at Iron Man's ass. Look at
extraordinary abilities where you can customize a growing roster of heroes.
Look at his ass.
And defend the earth oh, from ever escalating threats.
He has like a, oh, Iron Man has an ass oh, crack, dude. In his metal armor. Why did he make an why did he make a crease in his metal armor, dude? For the ass. Why did he do that?
Superhero
cuz he wants
every new
good,
region
dude.
Will
Chicks
be delivered at no additional cost.
Wait, what?
So our promise to the community.
Why are so many people wearing hats?
Won't have random loot boxes or pay-to-win scenarios.
No loot. Oh man. People
I didn't even know if there was
no
any
bullshit like, in the game.
This game represents a collaboration across Crystal Dynamics.
What does that mean? What does that mean?
I know you're out here. Eidos Montreal. These guys are here. Nixie Software.
Yeah.
Our new Crystal Northwest studio.
Yeah.
And everyone
people are
at Square
like,
Enix.
Yeah. Yeah.
So our game is about embracing your powers and living your superhero dreams. We have an exclusive gameplay demo in our booth that will show you more of the core
it's on the show floor
it's
right now.
It's original story and our superheroes in action.
At this very moment, all your cars are being
so,
destroyed.
So, Marvel's Avengers will release worldwide
today.
On PS4.
Right now.
Xbox One.
Yesterday.
Stadia and PC.
It was already out a year ago. You guys haven't downloaded it.
We got you covered. And we're excited to be partnering with PlayStation to bring some awesome surprises to the PlayStation audience.
Exclusive
Spider-Man exclusive.
Early beta access. And unique benefits that we'll be revealing in the future.
Unique benefits. I've heard this.
You said no bullshit. And then you throw bullshit.
One final glimpse into our world.
Glimpse.
Including when can I see your Amos? Get to play this game.
Can I meet the Amos family?
This is what's next for the Avengers. Thank you, true believers.
This was their closer. This was it.
Progress, Hank! I have a plan, but it's risky. Hank, that's
I thought Nuki no Nuki looked better than this. And that got 2 seconds.
Unbelievable. It worked.
Ant-Man. Is that Ant-Man?
It's sort of cute when they're small.
Ah, I didn't doubt you for a second, Hank.
Is that Paul
Hank
Rudd?
Him.
I don't get it.
It was an Ant-Man teaser.
Thanks,
Ant-Man's
Hank.
Gonna be in it.
Okay. All right.
Is that it?
Do Marvel's
that was it.
Time.
They should have closed with.
Wait.
Final Fantasy VII. They're going back to Okinuki.
Oh. What the fuck? What the fuck was that? Hey, what just happened?
3, 2, 1.
Okay. There you go.
What just happened?
No gameplay.
Yeah.
Very upsetting.
Yeah.
Very upsetting. A lot of info that's really great.
I mean, I feel like there was.
I thought they were gonna like reveal something
Tony
huge.
Flying and he did a barrel roll. I was like, that was like Ant-Man.
Yeah, you saw like a montage there at the end of him like in space. Yeah.
They close with Ant-Man cameo.
Like
I thought we were gonna get like a demo though.
Yeah, that's what I was hoping for.
Said that though.
He said another glimpse of gameplay.
But
she
said you could play it on the showroom floor, but they don't show gameplay.
Oh, in the booth.
Yeah, you
oh, okay.
In the booth, you
so
can
we
go
need
play.
To play it this week.
I mean, yeah, Tim. I booked you an appointment. You have an appointment to play, yeah.
Very exciting stuff. Ladies and gentlemen of Twitch, thank you very much for joining us.
He seems legit pissed off.
Are you ready to get the thing going?
He's like, fuck you. I think me and you.
Yeah, I got you an appointment. You fucking
3, 2.
What's up and welcome to
Did they not know that we were watching that? What is
Square
this?
Phoenix's
3, 2.
2019 live press conference. I'm Tim Geddes. This is Andy Cortez. That is Greg Miller. We are Kind of Funny Games. If you're unfamiliar with us, you can go to youtube.com/kindoffunnygames. You can stay right here
Greg
on twitch.tv
mad,
slash kind of funny
Look
games.
At him.
Click the follow button that's on
anyone
the screen.
Anyone with a hair
here.
Swivel is
we
mad
do
inside,
daily
okay?
Shows about video games. We do daily shows about a lot of other stuff too.
Have you seen
movies,
Superman?
TV, music,
plenty of
books, just a lot of fun.
Mm-hmm.
But I would say that our core stuff that might be of interest to you is Kind of Funny Games Daily each and every weekday on twitch.tv/kindoffunnygames at 10 a.m. We come to you with all of the video game news that you need to know. It's really great. There's also another show we do, Kind of Funny Games Cast. We talk weekly about the games that we've been playing, big topics in the industry, things of that nature. This show right now is a perfect example of the type of conversations that we would have. We're going to get right into it. We are reviewing Square's press conference. Their first real press conference in a very long time.
Do you remember when the last one was?
The last one was 2015, I want to say, of them on, 2016 of them on stage.
Huh, okay.
Yeah.
And not doing, like, the direct model?
Yeah, we got the direct model last year, and that was very, very bad. I would say, I want to start this one off. I think this is easily the best conference. Granted, going into it, I knew it would be for me, having Final Fantasy VII Remake and Avengers both. I was impressed by what I saw. Final Fantasy VIII Remastered, never, ever expected we'd see that. So that was a very cool surprise. Ton of other remaster games in there that definitely don't speak to me, but people are going to be stoked about them. The Romancing Saga games coming to the West for the first time. Kingdom Hearts 3 DLC, like a first real look at it. Like
can I ask you
all this stuff is
a follow-up
great.
Question?
What's up?
You're saying that you think it's the best conference. Are you talking about for you or overall?
I think both. Easily both. I mean, look, at the end of the day, we got the beginning of this was 15 minutes of real
the guy on the right thinks the guy on the left is the dumbest piece ended of this shit with he's a ever
pretty
seen
big
in his
blowout
life.
Of Avengers, which is going to be a huge game. No gameplay. That's definitely a bummer. Mm-hmm. But through this ton of announcements, ton of games we didn't know about, there were brand new announcements here, ton of remasters. Like, I just feel like it kind of had a lot in it. Definitely had pacing issues. Definitely many of the trailers went on 2 to 3 times
way
as long as
long.
They should have.
Mm-hmm.
But at the end of the day, it's like we were talking about Ubi earlier, and it's like they had a Watch Dogs demo that like was like, oh, cool, at least you had this. I feel like this conference, in terms of production value, in terms of what they showed, how they showed the stuff, and gameplay to back it up, and announcements, and release dates, they kind of came with the heat in a way that I don't think any of the other conferences did. Andy?
Man, yeah, I disagree. I just thought a lot of the games just don't speak to me.
All right, so what's going on now? What are we going to do about this?
The guy on the left thought it was the greatest thing he's ever seen, and the other two guys are like, eh. The guy in the middle is like, eh, I don't know about that, and the guy on the right's like, you're an asshole for thinking that.
I think they all know.
But aside from that, I just don't really.
The middle guy doesn't even speak English. America. No, I'm kidding.
Avengers, super excited about it. It looks great. I love that they, I think they did the right thing to sort of showcase the voice actors because that, I think they recognize how much gamers care about who are voicing these characters that they love.
He has a good point. He has a good point there.
Idea, but we got to the games as a service part towards the end. I kind of like, I don't know.
Yeah, there's a lot of questions.
I think we're done with this, right?
I disagree as well, Tim. I don't think it was a
good Do you want to play some of that BR Fallout Outlook or no? I want that clip. Okay. Tomorrow's the Nintendo one.
Oh, they're fighting.
Wow. Oh my God. I think this started strong and ended strong, and I thought it got stuck.
Dude, he's red on the left.
Again, we talk all the time about, hey, our personal biases versus like what we're talking about. Obviously, the majority of the games in the middle, I don't care about. I'm just not that kind of gamer. But even beyond that, I thought just the pace, we were stuck in them forever. I felt for, and that's what I was seeing people who I know care about these kind of games talking about online as well. I felt like that whole middle section. Yeah, I mean, Life is Strange already out, you know, Octopath. Okay, it's on PC. We already know that. The Dragon Quest Builders thing going on forever.
What?
All these different things coming out. Just
dude, this guy needs to chill out for a second.
And ever and ever. And it was to the point that knowing that Avengers is coming, you saw the chat and.
This guy's like me, but even angrier.
I didn't know Avengers was coming. I had no idea about these games. It's for people like me who don't know what the fuck's going on.
We're just putting a bunch of stuff in there. Again, you have
to play Nico Nuki.
Oh my God, this Snapple went bad. Oh my God, it smells like shit. In terms of oh my God.
What's it called?
This is like
empty.
Sure one that, and I was just like, oh my God. Nuki like,
no.
Yeah. Well, I think that's also the fact
Neo
that Kino?
Yeah.
Nido.
Kani?
Only Kana.
Like, there was a lot more. There was Outriders here.
Yo, Troll Eater likes my shit.
That's a Western game that we hadn't heard
Look,
about.
Troll Eater posted
to, like,
some
eat
stuff.
To eat it?
Look, he said, at MT Warrior, lol. Our spirits are bound into one joke. Oh, yeah, yeah.
Diddy. Yeah. Okay, but let me tell you, the feeling of...
He stole my line. Let me tell you. Let me tell you about it. He stole my line. Guys, you know me. You know me.
Okay, but let me tell you, the feeling of being...
I'll let this one.
Never seen before.
We're looking at frame rates up to 120 frames per second.
AKA capability...
The most immersive console experience ever. What we really want to do is give developers the power to build the game they always envisioned.
We have hundreds of people across both our first-party studios as well as our third.
It's like, if you had to explain like who you are to somebody, like what, who are you? Just show them that clip.
I should save this picture, make my profile image.
Tell me about yourself. Let me just show you a clip
on those generation experiences today. It's an amazing commitment to content at Xbox Games. We're actually using SSD as virtual RAM. We're seeing 1 to 3 times performance increases over the current generation.
Video,
the combination of the SSD and solid state drive are really what gives you totally new
speed.
I'll send this to like Twitch fails. Are you gonna be there for tomorrow's Nintendo conference?
No.
You have work tomorrow?
I work every day. on the street corner selling my body for nickels.
Oh.
Find more Nico one. What is it called? What's the name of it?
Onikana. Onikami? Onikuni? 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 Onikuni?
Ninokuni.
Onikuni? Onikuni? Onokuni? Oh, we never played the rollerblade. All right, well, it's been an 8-hour stream, my man. It's been fun, though. This whole stream has been great so far. Rape. I should be getting, I'm ordering that mini fridge. It's not a big deal, really. What else? What's a big deal, though? Nothing, really. Oh, Bikini Bottom Battles on Steam. Wait. They might show it here. They showed some pretty cool games. There's at least a handful that we care about, so that's good. Better than nothing. You know? You got some good ones. You know, if you could pick out a hand, they have really a great selection of thingies. Crystalis is free to play. The debut demo available until June.
I can never even find the games. Like, I just want, there should just be a site that's like, they talked about this game in order, like, as they announce them. It's like you look for the name and it's just like Marvel, Final Fantasy, Marvel, Fantasy, Marvel. I'm like, what's the Nico Nuki one? You know? You know what I'm saying, MT?
Yeah. I'm sure there's something like that, but I don't know where it is exactly.
Me neither, man.
They have the Steam. Everything got released on Steam. This free-to-play came out right now. I don't know. Oh, it already came out. It's been out for 10 years already.
Is it on like Twitter or
something? Keen. This looks interesting. I like these puzzle games. They're easy to play, you're chilling.
Oh, that car racing one looked cool too, with the little tiny cars. What was that called? Tiny Car Racer.
I don't know. I'm the worst reaction. I don't remember any of the games I just watched. Oh, this looks cool, like Abyss Odyssey. The thing about Steam games, like, you forget about these games, and it's like randomly been out for a month already. Barbarian? Where are these games were announced? I need to look through my. I need to just delete the whole wish list and restart it. There's too many games. Immortal Realms Vampire Wars. Oh shit. Quantum League. What? Kunai. This looks like a game I'd like.
Thank you.
Huh? Who are you? Are you still looking for the game?
I am. I can't find it.
We should have wrote down these games when we're watching them.
I found the footage of it, but since it's like a live stream, I tried to skip ahead and it screwed it all up.
What about, look up Okinaki. It's Okinaki. Oh, yeah.
Okinako. No.
It's Okinaki. Oh, God. What did I just look up?
Oh, Oninaki. O-N-I.
Yeah, that's what N-A-K-I. I said.
N-A-K-I. Oni. Oninaki. That's the one. That's what we want. It says August. I thought it said July. I wasn't really paying attention, guys.
Yeah, oh, is it only for PS4?
It said Steam.
Is it Steam?
It said Steam.
At the end,
it said Steam on it. This trailer was released on February 13th.
It's already been out. It's been out for 40 days already. That guy would be like, we already know well about it.
Can I pre-order it? How much is it?
40 years. Games cost your life now.
There it is. Oni.
What was that other game they showed? The Darkness? The Darkness? The Darkness? The Dark?
I added it to my wish list.
I'm sure you'll see that later. Over Darkness? Darkness? Dark? 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 What is it called? The Darkers? The Darksiders? The Darksiders. It's gotta be.
No.
No.
What was it called? It was called...
The Overdarkers?
Overlander.
Over Dark Hurts.
It was by Crystal Dynamics. You gotta type in Square Enix Crystal Dynamics.
Look how I spelled Square.
And it's called Avengers.
That's not it. No. What was that fucking game called?
It was called The Dark Crystal.
Was it really?
No. It wasn't Crystal Dynamics. I thought it was Crystal Dynamics. That's true.
Particularly different.
Right. Oh, yeah.
Is IGN's James Duggan.
I type in Square Enix new IP and it says Oninaki. Son of a bitch.
The storytelling.
What's it called?
Oh, here it is.
The companions each have their own quest.
What was it called?
I know it's not.
Outriders. It's called and Outrider.
Normal size, like cruise size spaceship, and then it was like
Outriders is a co-op sci-fi massive... shooter from the creator of Bulletstorm.
Yeah. That's what I want that game.
That's the one I think doesn't exist. I think that's a fake game, and it'll never come out.
This game looks sick, dude. You guys are amazing. They didn't show any gameplay with it.
Yeah, because it doesn't exist. There's no.
What are you talking about?
It doesn't exist. That's what I'm talking about. It's a fake. Those people are actors. They're not even real developers. It's a conspiracy. These huge corporations create fake games to announce just so they have content, you know.
I should just make a
that's
GIF
like of- the yeah, that's like the GIF of Michael Jackson meme eating the popcorn.
I should do that when like make it a command so people can
and
type it in.
And it's fitting too. It's fitting that you would have a similar meme as Michael Jackson. I should chip it.
Cause he's white.
Michael Jackson was black.
All right, put his picture in a paint.net image and try to copy the color of his skin and compare it to mine, which has a lighter color.
I always expect on these things like somebody to come out with something crazy, like mind-blowingly, like holy shit, I didn't know that was even possible type thing. But they never do. It's always the same old crap and the weird way of talking about it.
GameSpot knows what they're doing. Wait, they posted 3 videos of the same video. Remake gameplay premiere, release date, cinematic trailer. Dude, GameSpot is like farming views, dude. Final Fantasy Remake trailer, then they have the gameplay premiere video, then they have the extended release date. What the fuck? It's like they split the one segment into 3 videos. Holy shit. That's... I can learn a thing for two...
Tricky. What is that? Raw chicken. What is that? Go back.
I knew you were gonna say something about it. What a great trailer though, let's talk about that. So when does this Outsider game come out? That will come out for sure. Summer. Oh,
never.
Next year.
It's like it's coming out in a week. Let's see what it looks like. We can't do that because it doesn't exist.
Doc shook Hollywood with his presence. Alpha, are we gonna play some VR or what's going on with you? What's going on with you, Alpha?
I haven't played it yet. I don't know how to play. I don't know how to do it.
Just kill people.
That I know how to do.
Yeah, tomorrow's the Nintendo.
Of course, Nintendo, of course.
I'm excited because that's the only chance Mega Man Legends comes out. Nintendo's going to release
Legends.
I think.
They might. I heard rumors. There's rumors circulating.
No.
About a Mega Man Legends Remake. You haven't heard anything about that? For the Nintendo Switch. Mega Man Legend.
It was gonna come out for the Wii U, but they canceled it or some shit. The 3DS it was gonna come out for.
No, it was on the Wii U. And they canceled it. And they're like, oh shit, let's put it on the Switch.
Chuck Norris, coolest guy in the world, giving the keys to Keanu Reeves. That's true, I guess.
I think Keanu's probably way cooler than Chuck Norris. I don't know, though.
Wait, what? What'd you say, Al? What'd you say, Alf? What?
Huh? Yeah. Well, that was fun. That was interesting. I like to look at the new games coming out. I'm excited to see all the new games.
And my favorite game was this one, Destroy All Humans Remake. That's the best game. This whole E3, this is the best game. Like the weird, funny dynamics
between the two. So was there some kind of, what was that, Eat Meat? Really cool, was there an Eat Meat simulator? Fun, like, scroll down. Normally not expect.
It's, it has scroll down. Tongue-in-cheek humor.
Right, keep scrolling. Exactly.
Oh, it's the hot dog VR game. So where is it? It's just pre-alpha. It's a little bit further out. What?
So, like, we're in pre-alpha. Why is it gonna be a hot dog? Why can't it be a smart dog?
Fuck, did you just pull some fucking vegan feminism shit on me?
Why can't the hot dog be like
I didn't even know those exist, okay, I'm sorry.
Shaved head haircut. Okay.
Wow, fuck. Wow. Surge 2, oh yeah.
I loved Surge 1.
Damn.
I have no idea what that is. Can you believe all these games? Like, people are making these, man. How come I want to make a game? How do I get in on this shit?
Well, first you need $1 billion. I think we've covered it all. We're all caught
look
up
at
on
the,
everything.
The haircut. That girl had the haircut.
Todd Howard. What the hell? This is rare. It's like a party. Todd Howard chilling, dude. That'd be dope to be at that party, you know?
Like, I don't know, man. For people to get into positions of
gameplay trailer
power like that, you have to be a certain kind of person, you know?
What?
You know what I'm saying, MT? You know what I'm saying?
Shut up.
You know what I'm saying, dude?
No.
You know?
Well. Masquerade, yeah, I do want to play the first Vampire Masquerade. Someone's asking, MT, why are you so cool? Well, you know, sometimes,
nobody's talking.
Someone said, MT, what's your favorite game so far? Well, basically, Nintendo, I mean, I'm hoping the Nintendo one gets better, you know, games coming up.
Hey, MT, what... Do you think they'll announce Mega Man Legends tomorrow at the Nintendo conference?
There's a good chance. Good chance. I'm glad you asked.
If you could see one game tomorrow at the Nintendo conference, what would you like to see?
Mega Man Legends.
Mega Man Legends. That's a good one. That's a good choice.
I want to see 3DS.
If I had to choose, that would be the choice that I would choose for Mega Man. I'd choose for Mega Man Legends would be my choice.
Watch. Dude, watch. Dude, watch it. Watch it actually come out.
Dude, it's gonna. It's gonna come out. We could will it into existence. Like a spirit bomb. Everybody in the chat, give us your spirit for Mega Man Legends.
Oh, that's all I have to say about that. Oh.
That's one I want to play. Youngblood.
Batman Youngblood. No. Do you want to play some Fallout, or are you going to sleep soon? What's happening? Let's play some Fallout, dude. I don't off the books. The stream's over. Basically, we could just play Fallout and chill. I mean, it doesn't have to end. We don't have to do anything crazy. It's been a solid 8 hours. You know, I left half the time to take shit and stuff. Basically, I was there. We can play the Blade game together if you want to before bed. I mean, you don't have to go to sleep right now, Alpha. I mean,
I think you should play that.
By myself?
And I'll watch. Okay. Yeah.
Oh.